They wanted to build it back in the roaring 20s, but the Navy said no. Then came the 1960s and a new push, a bridge spanning the bay, a wonderful gateway to the 20th century for a quiet little community that voted against it, but ultimately had to accept change was on its way. And the joys of small-town life? Well...
You couldn't be in a hurry in Coronado before 1969 when that bridge opened.
Coronado was a totally different town back then.
And so we lived very simply.
After 1969, things started changing in Coronado for the good and the bad.
None of us believed it was going to happen.
A beginning and an ending today in San Diego.
I don't approve the bridge because it breaks the tradition of Coronado and it makes it too commercial.
In my opinion, Coronado will increase greatly in population.
I'm not going to go on it.
We won't be the quiet little city that we were before.
And I think it's a bad thing, myself.
But it will benefit some of us, and though many will be hurt.
The beginning, the dedication of the 2.2-mile San Diego-Coronado Bay Bridge. And the ending, the last day for the old Coronado Ferry, 83 years old.
My name is Bill Ring, and I worked on the Coronado Bridge from 1967 to 1969. And the first thing we did is we had to locate a barge to drive in the pilings to start putting the bridge together. And then once they were driven in, they filled them with concrete, put panels on, built up a pier. We got on top of the pier and we worked our way up the bridge. And when we got to the top, then we had to locate what's called bearing pads, and the girders were going to sit on those. And they had to be pretty precise because the girders were all manufactured up in Richmond, California, and barged down here. And they had to fit. And we had to measure the height of those things every 10 feet so they know how much concrete to pour on there to flatten them out. And the last one to go in, a section that was about 33 feet long, we went up the night before they were to pull it up there, and we measured the distance. And it was about a tenth of a foot longer than the section that was going up. So the next morning, it was overcast, kind of cool, and so they started lifting this piece into place. Well, I got it almost into place, and the sun came out. And when the sun came out, the bridge expanded like that and locked the last section in place, out of place, until later in the day when it cooled off enough that the bridge kind of gave up and they could lift it into the final position. And when they did that, then they could bolt it in and complete the bridge.
On the San Diego side, they anchored the bridge in Barrio Logan. A lot of poor families were displaced against their wills. So they established Chicano Park and created these murals, a way of turning their pain into artful protest. That's now the largest collection of outdoor murals in America and a national historic landmark. Meanwhile, across the bay here in Coronado, tourism soared, property values skyrocketed, world-class restaurants and shops, some fortunes made along the way, a lot of traffic created, and a suicide problem second only to the Golden Gate Bridge, for which lasting solutions are being developed.
Hi, my name's Joe Dittler. I lived in Coronado since 1966. I have the advantage of having been here before the bridge, and I'm very proud of that because the memories of pre-bridge are very special, and I'm just very grateful to have those.
I'm Mary Gwen Brummett, and I'm a Coronado resident of many decades now. We came here when my husband was on Navy orders in 1947.
Hi, I'm Michael Napolitano, and my family has been in Coronado since 1920. That's when my grandfather and my grandmother opened the California Market on the other end of Orange Avenue. And subsequent to that, after my dad returned from the war in the Pacific, he ran the day and night market.
When we went to the city to take children to medical specialists or to see a movie, we took the ferry.
The cars would line up on Orange Avenue from 1st Street to 4th Street to wait for one of the two or three ferry boats, depending on the time of day, to take us across the bay to San Diego. After 1969, things started changing in Coronado.
It brought a lot of business to Coronado, a lot of tourism.
We've all benefited and adapted entirely. It's fine now. It's a wonderful place to live.
Progress and change is always complicated, and the bridge is no exception. There is no doubt, however, it is truly a thing of beauty, an engineering masterpiece, and probably a necessity. It surely has pulled a sleepy town into modern times. 50 years ago, a way of life ended, and a new era was born.
And I suppose I'm in the front of the line saying happy 50th anniversary, Coronado Bridge.
I want to say happy birthday, Coronado San Diego Bay Bridge.
So for the 50th anniversary of the Coronado Bridge, well done.
Hi, I'm Coronado Mayor Richard Bailey. And on behalf of the cities of San Diego and Coronado, the many people that had a hand in building, designing, and maintaining the Coronado Bridge, and the millions of people that have traveled across the bridge over the years, we take a moment to reflect on the beauty of the bridge and its significance to our region. Since the bridge first opened in August of 1969, it has forever left an impression on the skyline of San Diego and the character of Coronado. So here's to another 50 years to the iconic Blue Bridge that connects our region and brings us all closer together.